let's get going. Tifa's got some very important business for us. Wait. Wait. Is there any shinies? I didn't check. Okay. It doesn't look like it.
Sorry. Did I wake you?
Nope. What's going on?
Oh, it's nothing, really. There's just something I need to ask you. So, can we talk?
Sure.
Great. But not here. Follow me.
You hold on one second. Can I go into these rooms? The door is locked. Okay, she wants to go talk on the balcony, which is like literally still within listening distance. Door is locked. Okay.
You know that I killed her. So, who is she? Or rather, what is she?
There's a weird guy down here. Can I talk to him?
Pardon me, sir, but you don't look very well. An old war wound acting up, perhaps? If so, I can certainly empathize. I myself fought for the company once upon a time, and my body's never let me forget it.
Sorry, Tifa. I wonder if she'll get mad at me for keeping her away. It seems like this game is very aware of the player running around. Okay. Okay, I guess we're going a little farther out of listening distance. Is there any items?
Do you think Midgar's over there? Anyway.
There's something I need to ask you, too.
Shoot.
That night, 5 years ago, at the reactor, I saw you lying there. Saw your wound and all the blood. I figured it was too late.
Yeah? Wait, what are you implying? That I died? That I'm some kind of imposter? Can't believe I'm having this conversation with you. But here we are. Here, look. My scar. That proof enough? After you left, Zangon found me. He's the one who brought me to the clinic. He risked his life carrying me out of the reactor and down the river. Wasn't just him, though. There's the doctor who operated on me all night, and the nurses who looked after me for days on end. I'm here now because they were there for me then. And where were you again? In fact, where have you been this whole time? For 5 years!
You know I can't tell you that.
Of course you can't.
Just tell her.
Sorry, I just need some space.
Don't upset Tifa again, jeez. Run into doorknobs. Powerful warrior, but railings. It doesn't look like there's anything down there, so.
I thought we could just pick up where we left off, like nothing had changed. But I guess I was wrong.
Guess so.
I was so happy to see you again, but maybe I shouldn't have been.
Jeez, just wake everyone up. Nah, I'm just kidding. Yeah. I'd be pretty upset too. Wait, do I have all the materia that... Okay. Okay. I'll just leave it as is for now.
You two fight?
No.
We have enough problems as it is. Copy?
Night.
Tomorrow is another day.
Yeah, never meet your heroes. Turn into a psychopath and burn your whole village down and cut your friend and maybe that's just a little overboard. Yep, still no items. I don't know why I keep looking, but... I'll say it.
What's this?
A gift from our humble establishment. Though it may not look like much, it should help you to break the ice with those you meet.
Queen's blood?
Oh. The DLC. Oh, it's the card game. You can now play with the card game. Queen's Blood, find others denoted by the icon around the world and challenge them to matches. Should you win, they will often give you new cards to add to your collection. Defeating players will also give you the opportunity to fight other opponents in different towns. You can also build and edit decks by selecting card decks from the menu. Oh boy. Final Fantasy VIII all over again. Sure, why not? I have no idea how to play. Each player takes turns placing a card on the board in one of the three lanes that span from left to right. First, try placing a card on one of the highlighted tiles adorned with an emerald pawn. Okay. Okay, it's telling me to put this one on here. Once card is placed, its power is added to your lane total. New positions will also be added to the board, which are tiles that emerald pawns upon which you can place cards. The yellow number in the top right corner of the card is its power, while a card will add to the board are indicated by yellow squares in the graphic at the bottom. Okay, so I guess it added those two pegs that I can add cards to. Interesting. So now it's their turn. Okay. Next, place a card so that one of its yellow tiles overlaps with one of your existing positions. Okay. One of your cards positions t- position tiles overlaps with a position control. The positive rises. The position rises in rank. As there are two pawns on that tile now, that position is rank 2. Cards can now be placed on positions equal to or higher than their rank, which is denoted by the number of pawn symbols in the top left corner of the card. Thus, in order to play more powerful cards, you'll have to raise your rank of your position. So now I can play that number, this Riot Trooper. Yep, okay. One of your card's position overlaps with one of your opponent's. You claim that position is yours. Note, however, that claiming a position will not raise its rank. Gotcha. Do you still can play a 3-star monster? You can keep track of who is winning a lane by looking at the point totals on each side of the board. The numbers on the left represent your power, the ones on the right represent your opponent's. You may notice that some cards have tiles with red borders. These are the tiles that are affected by the card's ability. Place cards effectively to make the most of their abilities and amass more power and more lanes than your opponent. In the event that you cannot place a card, you can pass with triangle. When both players pass consecutively, the game will end. Okie dokie. This has an ability, right? That gives a plus 2. Huh. So that's his ability, gives a plus 2 to that tile. I think there's a good chance I win that tile. So I should probably focus on increasing, because they have a 3 over here, like that's bad, I'm assuming. Let's do that. Hopefully I can draw another pawn that gives 2. Okay, I'm winning this one. I'm guessing I need to do something like this. Change the tile. Otherwise, what is this? Yeah, okay, I think this one is the one that I want. Do that. So type 5. Oh. Dang, I don't have a 3. Yeah, I don't have a 3 on the board. Kind of tough. That, increase those two. That seems like a decent play. Yeah, I think the best play is this one. Or this one. Then they have to pass. And I win this line. Okay, so now, Okay, and I can play the 3 on that board. we have to pass. Do that. I can play the squirrel. Oh, I can play... raise the power of allied cards. Okay, unfortunately this is the bottom, so I don't think it's going to do much. So I do this one. And I just dominate. Still can place one more, so... I think I do this, or do I do this? I think I do this one, because it gives me two. And then now I pass. Once the game is over, each player's total score, player score is tabulated. Only the player with the higher power in a lane has their power added to their score. In other words, no matter how high your score in a lane may be, if it is less than your opponent's score in the same lane, it will not count towards your score. After collecting the winner for each lane and adding their score lanes up, or their lane scores up, the player will with the higher total score wins. I think that's me. Flawless victory. You can have more cards in your collection by winning them off of players. Okay, boost purchasing from shops. Okay. Interesting. I wonder if there's a meta game. Okay, so I can challenge people. Okay, I see an icon. Is it locked? Nope. And I will help myself to this nice item here. And a bottle of ether. Great, I can run. I need to walk. This is Tifa's room. And Aerith. What, they got a balcony? What kind of... It's not fair. Okay. Screw that chair. I'm assuming that there's nothing, not gonna be anything up here, but might as well double check. Oh, wait. Second there, I thought this was the objective again. Okay. Okay. Nothing up here, but doesn't hurt to check. That railing. Okay.
Of course, this is only the most recent in a series of crises. Multiple reactor bombings, followed by the fall of the Sector 7 plate, culminating in this unprecedented destruction, caused by a massive tornado which swept through Sectors 0, 1, and 2. After a briefing with Shinra investigators, Mayor Domino released a statement, declaring the tornado to be, quote, weather warfare, perpetrated by the infamous insurgent group known as Avalanche. The administration also suspects the involvement of...
Good morning, sir. I must apologize for not introducing myself to you earlier. I'm Broden, the owner of this inn. Your companions have all stepped out. Oh, but Barrett left a message he wanted me to pass along to you. You missed roll call, soldier boy. Luckily, you're on leave for the day. Don't waste it, though. Get your equipment checked ASAP. Sound advice?
Dress your party's gear, but okay.
Perhaps a trip to the arms dealer is in order?
Good idea.
Can I get my special stuff?
By the way, Cloud, do you have any folios on you?
Yeah.
In that case, you might also want to pay a visit to Magnata Books. They have stores all over, but the first official one was built here in Calm, and their resident scholars are remarkably talented. If you want to unlock the true potential of your folios, you should go see them. The first customization is always free.
Good to know. Oh, there's Red 13.
Finally. Rough day yesterday, huh?
You've been waiting for me?
I've been waiting for a chance to thank you properly. Without your help, I'd still be in Hojo's clutches, trapped in that lab.
Was nothing.
Even so, I owe you a debt. Until it's paid, I'm going to accompany you.
Yay! Good doggo.
Oh, If you're getting your equipment checked, have them check mine while you're at it.
Sure thing. The Rook's got a backbone.
I'm looking up something quick. Okay, I guess it's a good cat, not doggo. I was like, yeah, I swear, it's like, you know, looks like it. That was more important than continuing the story. Okay. Overcoming challenges, helping out people in need, and exploring the world will help deepen your party's bonds, thereby increasing your party level. The higher this level, the more skills and abilities will be available in your folios. Okay, go beat people at card games. That seems pretty important to me.
I should just go up and challenge someone. Yeah.
Okay, this guy looks like he's a nub. I'm so used to playing so many RPGs before you talk to people you save.
What do you want? Don't scare me like that. You don't want to play Queen's Blood, do you? I was hoping that... Oh, what am I thinking? You look like you'd murder me. Oh god, this is too much. I think I'm gonna throw up. Don't give me that look. It's perfectly healthy for adults to cry too, you know.
Wow.
People call me Crybaby Ned. Because the more tears I shed, the better I get at Queen's Blood. Please play around with me.
Sure. Oh. Oh, okay, so that's the card I get for the reward, is the crab. Cool. Yeah, I have no cards to change out, so... Yeah. I got nothing. So... Let's see if... I can win at Queen's Blood. Alright. I was about to make a joke, like, can I mulligan? No. If you don't like some or any of the cards you've drawn, you can put them back in your deck and draw new ones. As you cannot play high-ranking cards right away, it is often a good idea to return them to your decks and hope of getting one that will help you early on. Yeah, so this goblin, probably not where I want to be, so... Oh shoot, how do I... Yeah. I have a bunch of 2-stars, so which ones are better? This one's got an ability, so I think this one as well, right? How do I... Yeah. Okay. So I'm first to play. Of course, I drew another 2. I think I do that, or can I do... Yeah, that doesn't seem to help. I want to do this one so I can at least advance the pegs over. Whoa. That's actually a bit scary. That only allow me to do that. What does this one do? Okay. And then, yeah, I can't play the other one. So I could play a 2. And what does that do? Okay. That seems like it'd be pretty good. Then I can play the Elf next turn, and 1, 2, 3. Try to close off. Let's do that. Gotta be one of these. Okay, I'm okay with taking and then having a 3-drop. Yeah. Try to take as much board space as I can take. I don't know if this is a good strat or not, but Okay, they have taken over the bottom row, so there's no more flawless victories for me. Oh, that's two drop. So can I put this in here and just take over these spots? Yeah, I think that's my play. Let's hope I can. Okay. Okay, a bunch of two drops. This might be okay. I think I don't have that many plays, right? I think I need to get some more twos, so if I do this one, I can play something else bigger on the bottom. Really need my three drop now. Okay. That'll increase this so I can play two turns, two twos on here. So I like that. So let's do this. Okay, so they're done playing the game. So I've won the top row already without playing anything. That seems pretty good. Yep, let's do this. We're kind of going to draw in the middle board, so. Okay. So, I've already won the top one already. So. What's going to be more impactful for the one guy? So, he does. Let's do this one. Power those up. Okay, so I want to see which one gives me higher. That makes it 4 and 8. This one makes it 5 and 7. Doesn't really matter which one I play. Yeah. Flawless victory. Sweet.
Oh god, I lost. But I feel a lot better after having a good cry. There's nothing like a game of Queen's Blood to relieve some stress. Speaking of, you look like you've got a lot weighing you down too. It's written all over your face. Trust me. Crying does wonders. You really ought to try it.
On that note, this is probably a good spot to stop the episode. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next episode.